Good morning, children. So far we have done the monohybrid and dihybrid cross, how Mendel had come up with his three laws of inheritance and what these three laws of inheritance were, and what about the factors, what is the factor was an imaginary unit which Mendel thought to be carrying as a heredity. And in the later on, that is in the due course of time, see, one thing I would like to say here, that heredity is a very tough subject. It is a very, very difficult topic, because it is something which you cannot see by your eyes. None of the devices, none of the instruments can tell us where the factors are, what they look like and all. And that is why it is only an imaginary unit, and we can just perform the experiments on the basis of those hypotheses and come to the fact that whether they are really there or not. So Mendel conducted lot of experiments, and those experiments took lot of time. And then I said that in 1865 he presented his theories, that is the three law of inheritance, and everything is well made it in the form of a project, in the form of a booklet, and he presented it. And his thesis was never accepted because his ideas were much ahead of the time. Okay. Anyway, later on in year 1900, three scientists from three different countries, they also came to the same conclusion, and then he was regarded as a father of inheritance in year 1900. And later on, number of other studies have started. See, science always accumulates, science always multiplies, the knowledge of the science always multiplies. The previous knowledges of all different discipline of the science, they help in the discovery of the next thing. So after year 1900, the science has developed too much, and so it helped us to come up with the various ideas and to find the truth of the Mendelian experiment. So in year 1900, what Mendelian theories were discovered, later on the further work has been done, that I'll just for the historic point of view. In year 1902, Sutton and Bowrey put forward the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Where they said that the factors are actually located on chromosome. So one question was there, that is where the factors are located. In after long experiment and after experiment, in year 1952, it was established that DNA is the genetic material. That is, whatever chromosomes, factors, that is the genes are made up, they all are made up of DNA. And then we came out with the central dogma, which I already explained on this also. I told in the previous classes, that is the DNA makes RNA, and RNA makes proteins, and several proteins are directly expression, or some of the proteins may work as an enzyme, and these enzymes perform a particular type of function. Let us understand what happens when the capital T and small t type of factors are there. A combination, heterozygous combination, where the capital T, that is the dominant, and small t, that is the recessive, that is capital T for the tallness and small t for dwarfness, is there. Yet Mendel got only tallness, not the dwarfness. Why has it not reached to the intermediate combination, that is tall suppose were this much and dwarf was up to this much, then the intermediate plant should have been appeared in this case. Why it is not there? So after a lot of studies, we have come to know that tallness is responsible for making certain type of enzyme, and the dwarfness, that is the small t, is also making some enzymes. These enzymes are functional. These
that is the capital T or dominant characters enzymes are always functional, so they will be able to express their character. The small T, that is the recessive character, they may either have non-functional enzyme their enzymes either may be non-functional or they may not be producing any enzyme only, no enzyme produced, or they are in a very small quantity, that is least quantity. There may be three reasons, that is that small T or the dwarfness or the recessive correct is failed to express. Either the enzymes which are made are not functional, either in presence of the enzymes which are made by the dominant character, they are non-functional, or they are not functional only, or they may not at all an enzyme, they may not be even a protein, functional protein. So how will they be express their character? And or they may be least in quantity, so the effect is very very suppressed. Okay. Now what happens when capital T is there, it will be making functional enzyme, so it will be showing its tallness. That we know that the tallness in the plant is actually because of a hormone called auxin. We have studied in the control and coordination. The tallness or the height of a plant is actually depending on the hormone that is phytohormone, that is auxin. So these enzymes may be sufficient to produce auxin. They may be able to produce auxins, which may be boosting the height. They may not be able to produce auxin, or they are not an enzyme only, so they will not function for anything, or they are producing a very small quantity of auxin. So when the plant is dwarf, the quantity of auxin is so less that the plant's height does not increase. So these are the way which we have understood by the study of that is called central dogma, that is the DNA made RNA and RNA made proteins. Okay, so these are the various type of things which I discovered later on, which I added later on, since everything cannot be studied in this class. If you take bio in the higher classes, then we'll have the full elongated chapter on based on these topics. Okay, in 12th class we have got two chapters based only for heredity, and they are quite big chapters, that is the biggest chapters of the class 12. So then you can finish all your first talk about heredity if you want. Okay, today we are going to start the next topic, and one of the most important topic, at least for the Indian view, that is sex determination. People always wanted to know how or why a certain organisms are born as male or as female. When they were farmers, they were dairy farmers, they always wanted to have more of females than the males, so that they could get more and more milk. If they were poultry farmers, they always wanted to produce more of females, so that they can get more number of eggs. Okay. So the people always wanted to know, is there anything by which we can increase the number of males or the number of females? Those who are engaged in the drought, laborious works and all, they always wanted to have more of the bulls produced so that they can be engaged in the heavy activities. So the people have their own ideas. In India, we know that the human beings, that is in case of human, yeah, the more and more people wanted to have male child to be born than the female child. The reason may be anything, you all know that the people always have a preference, and they relate it with the continuity of their family. They say that if in my family there is no male, then my family will get over here itself. Because the daughter which is born actually goes into some other family, so she will be continuing with the other family. This is what the thought is, which is a wrong thought. Anyway,
will discuss here only the scientific explanation. We have nothing to do with the
what society thinks.
So people always wanted to know how is that a male or a female child is born? Why a certain child is born as a male or why a certain child is born as a female? What is the heredity? What is the heredity? So number of studies were conducted on this, and there was a scientist known as Hanking. He was doing his study on some of the insects, and then he accidentally come across a chromosome which is not looking like chromosome, because we always define chromosome as a thread like structure. But this particular thing which Hanking noticed in some insects was a dot like structure. And since he never even thought that the chromosomes can be dot like structure, but these unknown things are found in all the that is 50% of the sperms, and 50% of the sperm these never had. And those 50% of sperm which had these point like structure, dot like structures were there, they were fertilized with the egg which always had this structure.
I'll just tell you that how it is,
that 50% of the sperms, 50% of the sperms had dot like structure and 50% never had this. And the 100% eggs, all the eggs had this dot like structure. So when this dot like structure and this dot like structure came together, they produced female child. That is the female insect. Whereas when this and this fertilized, so they had only one dot like structure, other was not there, and these all lead to the formation of male. So Hanking was quite surprised. He said that these unknown structure are SX structure or X body. You know, in science we have generally, that is whenever we are unknown about anything, we just label it as X. So he called them as X body. Hanking was the first who came out with an idea of X body. Okay, now what are these X body? What are these X body? He could not explain anything further. Later on, number of experiments have been done, number of people have continued with their experiments, and they came out that these X body are nothing but they are chromosomes, and hence come with the X chromosome. Okay, the idea of X chromosome. Anyway, that was only historic point of view. Let us talk about the sex determination in human being. Sex determination in human being. We know that human beings are sexually reproductive organs. So, in order to give birth to a baby, we always require two individuals, one male and a female. So, suppose this is a female and this is a male. Human being has got 23 pairs of chromosome. Out of this 23 pair of chromosome, 22 pair of chromosomes are identical in females and males. 22 pair of chromosomes are identical in the females and the males. These chromosomes are known as autosomes. Okay? Whereas one pair of chromosomes are different in the females and the And this one pair of chromosome which is showing the differences in the sex, in the male and in the female, is known as sex chromosome, because it is clearly indicating that it is these chromosomes which are determining the sex of an individual, whether it is going to be a male or whether it is going to be a female. So all these studies were found that this sex chromosomes in case of females are X and X. Remember, we are not writing anything about the autosomes. Autosomes are those chromosomes which are same in both males and females. We are not writing anything about the autosomes because they are same. No, we will just eliminate it, we will just avoid it, we will just not consider them.
Okay, so in case of female, the sex chromosome are X and X, whereas in case of males, the X chromosome are sex chromosomes are X and Y type. So when the eggs are produced, females will produce eggs, and each egg will contain one X chromosome. When the males will produce sperms, the 50% of the sperms will have X type of body, and 50% of the sperms will have Y type of body. That is, they have got Y chromosome and they have got X chromosome. When this X chromosome fertilizes with the X chromosome containing egg, the child will have this combination, and this combination represent female. When this X chromosome fertilizes with this, again we get X and X, that is female. When this X chromosome fertilizes with this Y, we get X and Y. This is going to give birth to a male. And when this X chromosome fertilizes with this Y, it is also making a combination of X and Y, that is male. So what we see here? What we see here? That 50% probability is there of a girl child to be born, and 50% probability is there for a boy child to be born. Okay, so we have to understand three important things. We have to understand three important things here. Point number one. The female has got no role in determination of the sex, because female will always produce only one kind of egg, that is X kind of eggs. The sex of a born child, whether it's going to be a girl or a boy, depends on the male. Whereas in India, we are often blaming female to giving birth to a girl child. You might have heard or keep on hearing, now even the science has developed so much and India has got independent after so much of studies and all, so much of media we got, so much of education we got, so much of knowledge we got, so much of conscious we have become, yet we people are simply blaming women for giving birth to a girl child. A girl child or a lady will always, a woman will always produce only and only X type of X. What is her to do with the determination of sex in a child, that is whether the born child is going to be a male or female? It is only depending on the X chromosome or Y chromosome of the father. So the blame has to be given to the father. So all those mother-in-laws and all those other people who are always blaming the woman for giving birth to a girl child is useless, baseless and factless. That should go to the male. Second thing which we understand here, that the number of X chromosome bearing sperms and the number of Y chromosome bearing sperms produced are just equal. There is 50% of X containing sperms and 50% of Y containing sperms are there. So the 50% probability will be there that the child will be born with female, or 50% of the child will be born as male. There is no way by which we can increase the Y type of chromosome or X type of chromosome. There is no way by which we can increase this or increase that, or increase this or decrease that, or increase this, eliminate that. It cannot be. If that has to be done, that is only Y chromosome has to be produced, the man has to be defective, man should have only 45 chromosomes. Or man should be having Y and Y type of chromosome, which is not possible. Which is not possible. Both these cases will lead to some of the genetic disorder, genetic diseases, which are incurable, and such children will never be welcome in the family. Okay, so this type of situation, which we studied, where we see that the sex of a born child will be depending on the male, that is X chromosome or Y chromosome produced by the male, not by the female, and they are always equal. And third thing, there is no method by which we can increase the male or female, that is X or Y chromosome. So all that is different type of advertisement you are seeing, all those different type of foolish ideas which you are seeing in the newspapers, in the TVs, on the internet, where we are seeing that the so and so mantra is there, or so and so medicines is there, or some so and so topic is there, some so things are there which can give birth to only male child, not a female child. All these are rubbish. One should not believe on those facts. See, it is a probability that 50% children going to be a male or 50% will be female. So once the child is born, if someone says okay, use this thing and your child will be male, 50% possibility is there. It may be possible that the 50. All those who have got male child because of that type of thing, they will go and talk good about those people. Those who have got male child, they will never speak up. And people get the publicity by these type of things. And then more and more people start believing on. There is no such fact, there is no such extract, there is no such thing, belief or scientific evidence which says that by any of the techniques, the number of Y chromosome, or you can decrease the number of X chromosome. So three things we have to understand, that is the sex determination is depending only and only on the male, not on the female. There is an equal probability of a male child to be born or a female child to be born. And third, by no means we can increase or decrease the number of X chromosome or Y chromosomes to get the birth of more of male child or more of female child. Okay. So all these things we have to keep in mind, and this particular topic is included in class 10th only because of this, so that even after 10th class, many children will not opt bio, and they may go for commerce, or they may go for arts, or they may go for maths, or they may go for some other branches. They will also know about these basics, and they may have a healthy family head. They should not have any sort of tension, and they should not have any type of wrong belief. Okay, so that's all for today, children. We shall continue this with the next period. One more thing I would like to say: the test paper which I put onto the YouTube channel, hardly 18 or 19 children have taken test. It is not for me. I am going to get nothing. I am going to get nothing whether you take test or whether you don't take test. Okay? If you are taking, it is for your benefit. If you are not taking, it is for your benefit. I am not either checking the copy, checking of the copy is also done automatically by Google. And I have not even seen that how much marks who is obtaining and all. Okay? It is for your benefit. If you take the test is still available there, and I have not withdrawn the test. I have not closed the responses also. So you can take the test anytime. Furthermore, test I will be including in the due course of time. Okay, thank you, children. That's all for today.